Hello students, welcome to the 8th class on economic survey volume 1. In this class we will be dealing with science and technology in India. Now in this chapter we will be understanding India's development in the domain of science and technology. Science and technology ke kshetr mein India mein kya kya developments hua hai. इकोनॉमिक सर्वे ने इस एस्पेक्ट को काफ़ी डिटेल में डील किया है. नाउ ब्रॉडली इस साल के इकोनॉमिक सर्वे ने तीन चीज़ों के ऊपर फोकस किया है. तो पहली चीज़ क्या है कि ओवरऑल जो इन्वेस्टमेंट है साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी में वो गवर्नमेंट सेक्टर वर्सेस प्राइवेट सेक्टर किस तरह का है. सेकेंडली The economic survey has dealt about the total number of patents, total number of publications and total number of developments in the domain of STEM. Science and technology, engineering and mathematics. And thirdly, economic survey has dealt with another important thing. That is the patent regime in India. And how it fares in comparison to the patent regime existing in the foreign countries. So first of all, we'll be understanding the R&D sector in India. Now R&D sector is also called as quaternary sector in India. It is the fourth sector apart from the primary, secondary and the tertiary sector. Now when it comes to this fourth sector of the economy, that is R&D sector, and R&D specifically in the science and technology domains, India is actually an outlier in it. Now what is meant by outlier in this? Now outlier means that India doesn't invest too much in R&D. Now when it comes to the investment that India was doing in the year of 2004 and 5 and the investment that India is doing now, that is in the year 2016 and 2017, the investment overall with respect to GDP, it remains the same. In 2004 and 5, the investment jo kiya tha, wo bhi 0.6% tha GDP ka. Aaj ki date mein bhi wo GDP ka more or less 0.6% hi hai. To jo investment hai in R&D sector, in research and development in science, वो बहुत ज़्यादा नहीं बढ़ा है. But अगर हम दूसरे देश लेते हैं जो इंडिया के आसपास है with respect to economic development, like we take the case of Korea and the countries which have surpassed India in the development, they actually invest more in R&D sector, in doing research and development in the domain of science. But India is not investing that much. And there is another interesting thing about R&D in India that is done in India. Most of the support to this R&D is provided by the government sector. Although this support has been coming down in comparison to the investment that is done by the private sector. But when we look at the R&D sector of the other countries, agar hum USA ka R&D dekhte hain, अगर हम इसराइल का देखते हैं, चाइना का देखते हैं, उनका आरएनडी सेक्टर में 2% ऑफ द जीडीपी है. वेयर एज इन इंडिया वी जस्ट हैव 0.6% ऑफ द जीडीपी दैट इज इन्वेस्टेड इन द आरएनडी सेक्टर. एंड दिस इज वन ऑफ द रीजन दैट व्हाई इंडिया इज नॉट एबल टू कम आउट विद इट्स ओन टेक्नोलॉजिकल डेवलपमेंट्स in various areas, in various domains. And that is one of the reason why the manufacturing sector in India hasn't moved fast. And that is another reason why India have not been able to develop its own softwares. Now, there is another important thing attached with it. Now, what is that? Now, when it comes to the investment done by the private sector, in India, the private sector is not ready to invest in this sector. It's only the 50% contribution that generally comes from the private sector. Though it is increasing, but it is nothing in comparison to the investment that is done in the R&D domain within the other countries. Agar USA mein dekha jaye to 90% of the investment is done by the private sector in R&D in the sciences. And same is the story of Korea, same is the story of Japan, same is the story of the European countries. But in India, there is no research culture. And this stands true also for the universities. India mein jitne universities hain, they are not ready to actually finance research and development in the sciences. And this is actually not getting, the sector is not getting push even from the government. Now, in order to give a push to this sector, it is important that we must actually bring about a change. But ye change kahan pe leke aana chahiye? Is change ko understand karne ke liye kya change chahiye, kya transformation chahiye? उसके लिए हमें अंडरस्टैंड करना पड़ेगा कि इंडिया का पेटेंट स्ट्रक्चर किस तरह का है. एंड इन ऑर्डर टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट थिंग वी नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड हाउ मेनी पेटेंट्स आर गेटिंग रजिस्टर्ड इन इंडिया. नाउ दिस इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग. नाउ इन 2015 एंड 16 45,000 प्लस पेटेंट्स वर रजिस्टर्ड इन इंडिया. बट अगर यूएसए में देखें ये वाला फिगर, इट स्टैंड्स आउट टू बी मोर देन 5 लाख पेटेंट्स वर रजिस्टर्ड. एंड इन चाइना अबाउट 11 लाख पेटेंट्स वर रजिस्टर्ड. सो व्हेन इट कम्स टू द रजिस्टरिंग ऑफ द पेटेंट्स, इंडिया एक्चुअली इज एन आउटलियर. इंडिया इट इज नॉट इवन नियर टू दीज कंट्रीज विद रिस्पेक्ट टू द रजिस्टरिंग ऑफ द पेटेंट्स. Now, when it comes to India's patent law, it is very anachronistic. It is not respecting the current demands of the society. It is not respecting the current demand of the researchers. There is another important thing about the patent regime in India. We just have few hundreds of the technicians who actually assess the patents of the innovators. So we are not even having the army of the patent officials who actually help in registering these patents. That is the reason that in India, if you want to register a patent, it will take you 4 to 5 years. But this is not the case in USA, this is not the case in China. There the patent registration is very fast. And there is another interesting thing about the patent. अभी बहुत important चीज़ है एक patent के बारे में. Now अगर किसी Indian को patent register कराना है तो हिंदुस्तान में उसको patent register कराना बहुत मुश्किल है. हिंदुस्तान में इस साल सिर्फ 500 patent core stem में register हुआ है. But यही लोग जब बाहर जाके register कराते हैं तो इन्होंने बाहर जाके 5,000 innovators ने बाहर जाके patent को register करा लिया है. So practically, if India wants to forge ahead in this realm of science and technology, we really need to first of all increase the investment that we are doing in R&D and especially in the science domain. And for that, first of all, we need to actually alter our education system. And in one of the chapters of economic survey, the government has highlighted the level of poor education, the standards that the students are not even able to achieve. So we need to actually give a push to the quality. We need to give a push to the standard so that we can derive benefits out of research and development in the domain of science and technology. And this year's economic survey has suggested a few things that we need to actually set up a national mission on bioinformatics, we need to set up national mission on mathematics, we need to set up a national mission with respect to cyber laws, cyber technology. Now by national mission with respect to biotechnology, if we will be setting up all these national missions, it will help us to go deep into these domains and to actually come out with new and sophisticated technology. It is not that the science and technology of India hasn't yielded anything. India has participated in the LIGO project. India has also sent the space missions to Mars and to Moon. But what we really need now, we actually need to intensify research. अगर पिछले सालों से comparison किया जाए, तो जो publication है हिंदुस्तान में of research articles, वो increase तो हुआ है, but it is nowhere near to the countries like USA, Korea, Israel and Japan. अगर Israel का हम केस लेते हैं, Israel जैसा देश सबसे ज़्यादा पैसा R&D में लगाता है, ताकि कुछ नया product, कुछ नई technology वो निकाल पाएं एंड उस टेक्नोलॉजी का यूज करके कुछ मैन्युफैक्चर कर पाएं और उसे ट्रेड कर पाएं. इजराइल एक ऐसा देश जो 4% अपना जीडीपी का इन्वेस्ट करता है. इंडिया में इट इज जस्ट 0.6%. सो फ्रॉम दिस थिंग यू कैन गेट एन आइडिया अबाउट व्हाट इंडिया एक्चुअली नीड्स टू डू विद रिस्पेक्ट टू द साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी एंड स्पेशली विद रिस्पेक्ट टू R&D सेक्टर. So this was all for the day. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is Brainy IAS. Now if you have any sort of query with respect to these economic survey classes, you can contact me at 84594000. So have a nice day. Bye bye. Take care.